Hi, welcome to TJ Idea for Innovation. Today we are with a new project called Heart Disease Detection using machine learning. So here we are main objective is in order to predict the heart attack detection. So whether the heart rate, depending on the heart rate or systole and the age of the person, we have taken certain 13 parameters on that. So like these columns we have. So next is we'll import the data set. So this is our data set. So we have taken around 303 of data sets. Open. So as we'll go, once the data is imported, we'll go to the pre-processing of the data. First, removal of the null values if it has any null values over the data. So let's know it will be removed. So click on remove null values. Remove missing data. If any columns or null values it has, it will remove the data, because in machine learning we cannot use the null value columns or rows in our in any of the data for the classifier. So next is data standardization. As we can see, the data is entirely having different units values. So it's like ones and hundreds it is there. So in order to have the same scale over that data, so we'll go for the data standardization of each columns. Yes, the data standardization is done. So here the data standardization. Next is we'll go for the fill outliers. So if the any data of here it is having the range out of range, which cannot be have the predicted proper value, so it may be a wrong entry over the data set. So we'll fill out the layers by the mean values. So it's done. So if any values is out of range, that will be re-entered with the mean value of the column. So next is decision tree. So we are using a classifier called we'll outplay this whole data to our classifier. Yes, the building classifier is done. So next is we'll apply the classifier with our test data. So we are taking around over that we are taken the 303 of data is there. So you can see, so still it's taking time to with the columns. Yeah, we have 303 of data is there. In that we are taking only 2% of data for the test data as a test data. Around 2% comes around 60 values, 60 columns of data. We are sorry, 60 rows of data will be taken to randomly to our testing. So let's check with the testing purpose. So take a data for the testing here. So we have taken the test data here, about 20% of data from the our main data set, and we have 243 of data is for the training, and remaining 60 data is taken as a test data. So now we'll start the prediction on the apply the classifier, decision tree classifier output. So that is, we will do the prediction on the test data. So apply the prediction. So here the labels will change as per to the prediction. So we can check here. So we can compare the targets. Sorry. So we can compare the targets. So certain changes will be there. So we can check at the 59, the column 59. So see that some changes is taken with the test data. This is our original test data taken. So this is a prediction data of the classifier output, which is done with the decision tree we are using here to predict the who will get the in the future of heart problems attributes of data, like age and CP, that is cholesterol. All this data will predict that whether they will get the heart problems. That is, if they are having the diastole of a very less diameter of over that less than 50, so then obviously they will get that heart problems in the future. So that is DGT is not is greater than, that is a normal person will be having the valve of in order to flow the blood properly. So this DGT label 50 is greater than, diameter is greater than the threshold of 50, so then obviously that person is normal, and if it is having less, so then you will get the, that is our prediction, which is done with the train data studying, and it is applied over the test data using a decision tree classifier. So after prediction is done, we will go to the graph, how it is distributing the data and classifying the data to the labels. So we will go to the graph, view graph. So next is this is a view graph. So you can see that the prediction is done with the age and there is cholesterol, old peak. So these are the values, attributes we are using to predict that whether the person will get the heart problems in the future. So this is nothing but it's a heart attack prediction in the future for that particular person. So these are the label ends. You can see we have in this, over this test of data, we are having about 9 labels. This will be variant with the different test data. So next is after we'll apply the confusion mat, we'll probably know the how many are true positive and false negative, and false positive and true positive, that is values from the confusion mat. So this is a prediction data. So from the confusion matrix we can calculate the accuracy. So we go the C, or there is 73.33, and this will be variant every time with a different test data. Here we are taking the obviously the data from prediction test data or train data with different values randomly. So we'll get every time it will change, this accuracy will be getting changed. So if I change that again, data for testing, so we'll change this data for testing, and we'll do the prediction. So now the prediction is will be different. Yeah, prediction is done. Next is we'll go directly for confusion matrix. So you can see the confusion matrix changed. So now the accuracy will be different. So this was just a slight change, it was there. So we will change with a different testing data again. You can check this, like this the accuracy will be changing every time as to our prediction and test data. Here we are randomly selecting the data with a train day, which is a one block of data. We are taking the around 20% of data only as a test data. So this is our prediction model, and this predicts the heart disease to the person who will be having this kind of parameters, and this kind of parameters if they are found. So obviously it will be predicted as a data who will get the obviously the some heart problems, that is we'll predict from this labels. So this is a test data, and the proper predicted data for the 60 values of test data is here in the prediction data. And thank you. This is a small machine learning project about the heart disease detection.